What's up, soil fam? All right, today we are here in the kitchen with me cooking one of my wife's favorite dinners. All right, I try to stay out of her way. I let the kitchen be hers, even though I'm someone who loves to cook. But every so often, I like to treat her to something special. All right, today what I'm gonna cook her is shrimp fried rice with some general style chicken with a little bit of a twist. All right, so why don't y'all join me and we're gonna show y'all how I do this. Things first, all right. These meals take a lot of prep, okay? So you're gonna probably wanna get some of this stuff done ahead of time, all right? So the first thing we're gonna do is get our rice started, okay? Of course, I love jasmine rice, you know. It's not the easiest rice to cook, but I love the aroma that jasmine rice puts off. So it's one of my favorites, not so much my wife's, but she likes it. She just don't like to cook it. Okay. So we're getting our rice going. Okay. Depending on how much you're going to actually use is how much you should cook. Okay. So there's no particular measurements, maybe a cup, cup and a half, 2 cups. All right. So however you feel, you know, you only got to cook what you're going to use, but you want to make sure you got enough. Because when that thing come out tasting delicious and you want more, you're going to have to go through all this again. All right. All right, soil fam. Okay, we back. We got our rice done. Got it out cooling. You know, a lot of people say, you know, it should be cooked and refrigerated overnight. I don't see no point in that, but you know, if that's what you want to do, do what you do. All right. We have one of our harvested chickens. All right. We're going to use that today. And I'm going to use the dark meat. Okay. You can use dark or white, whatever you prefer. I prefer the dark meat. So we're going to go ahead and get that together. Alright, here we go. One of our beautiful birds. Yes. Ready to do our family some great justice by nourishing our body, okay? So, all I'm gonna do is get my dog meat. Okay, just gonna separate my thighs and legs. Here we go. Another beautiful breast. And that will be enjoyed very soon. And those wings. Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and separate. My thighs and my legs. Okay. We want to go ahead and debone. Your dark meat. Okay. Said, sharp knife. Important. Need it. Shouldn't be doing a lot of sawing when you're dealing with this kind of stuff, because accidents can occur. And they will. Alright guys, alright. We deboned our chicken. Alright, we're going to move this out the way. I'm going to call my sous chef in here at the wild, see if she can bag this stuff up. Alright, got us a bowl here, and what we're going to do is just cut our chicken up into nice size pieces. Okay. Skin on. It's the way I prefer it. So. Not the biggest fan of chicken fat, so I remove as much of that as I can. Like a good piece. I'm gonna need that just like that. Like that, like that. Boom. And there we go. I Again, guys, this is going to be completely up to you on how much you decide you're going to prepare. If this is more than enough for me and my wife to eat. And leftovers with this chicken is not the best. And I'm a big proponent of leftovers, but give it a little bit of season to your taste, whatever you decide. One thing that's really necessary, a little bit of salt. I tend to use pink salt a lot here. A little bit of pepper. And I like to hit it with a little bit of seasoned oil. Okay, just a little bit. To your taste. Okay, guys, next up, we want to get us some flour. I'm going to do 3/4 of a cup, okay? 3/4 of a cup of flour. And about equal that, or a little less, of cornstarch, okay? Right. Mix that well, okay? To go. All right. That's a nice, beautiful, coated chicken. And on to the next step. All right. Whatever method of frying you usually use, have at it. I prefer my deep fryer. Okay. Love this thing. It is, to me, the easiest and best way to fry. We use peanut oil. You know, some people got allergies to that, so use the kind of oil that's best for you. Alright. Of course, if you're frying, you know, something that can, that won't burn in the process of you using it, will be best. Okay, so what I'm gonna simply do is, I got my grease up to 350. I'm going to individually drop each piece of that beautiful bird into the grease. Never was burned by hot grease before. Got yourself lucky. It is not a pleasant feeling. Try not to overstuff your fryer and let your bird do its thing. All right, guys. One batch of chicken. Done. See? Simply load your next batch. Same thing as before. Not a problem. Drop them in carefully. Get them going. Beautiful. So, you can't ask for no better than this. I heard about the double frying method, and I have tried it, and it does work. It works great. So, I will be frying all these again. Alright. I do find that it actually gives you a more crispier outer coating, and the inside stays just as juicy. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this first fry down out of the way, and I'm gonna start with some of my other stuff, come back, and I'm gonna fry the thing again just before dinner time. Okay, these are some eggs, all right, aka butt nuggets. Two or three should do. And these are eggs from our girls. So eggs that we have gotten out the backyard. See there, very beautiful. We got an array of colors. What more to come? So everything is exciting to open up the coop to see what's going to be there. That's a lot of eggs, okay? A lot of protein. Got my wok here. Make sure it's nice and hot. What I'm gonna do is pour me a little bit of olive oil. Okay. Here we got some shrimp. Maybe half a pound, maybe a pound. I didn't measure. Don't care, as long as there's plenty of them. And just good to go. Of course it's me. They didn't even need that much cooking. So alright guys, we're gonna go ahead and cook our eggs.
I need carrots and peas. You would dice up me a carrot.
One carrot.
One carrot. Use the cutting board. Look at the gas. You see all them little bits right there? From the shrimp. I love it. Incorporate the taste of that shrimp into the mix. My goodness. Yes.
Can I move these eggs?
Use the cutting board so I can get like uniform cuts. Out. Y'all can't see, but she's coming right behind me, cleaning up everything as I mess it up.
Somebody gotta do it.
Who wouldn't love cooking when you can have that? The mess up without the cleanup. Like, that is amazing. Alright guys, what I did, I took one fresh pineapple and cut it in half. I cored it out, and this is what we have here, okay? We have our fruit from our pineapples in a bowl separately, and all these juices, magnificent juices, yes. So, we're going to let that sit, and we're going to carry on. Alright guys, while we're waiting for my pan to heat back up, what I like to do is take some of my shrimp and I cut them up into chunks. And the reason I do that is because I love to try to have a piece of shrimp in almost every bite when I eat my rice. So, yeah, big shrimp look beautiful on top of the rice, but I'm talking about eating it. You know what I mean? So I'm about what it tastes like. So that should be good, along with what I got this whole. And with any good luck, you're going to get a piece of shrimp every time you take a bite of this delicious rice. Next up, we're going to go ahead and get our veggies going, okay? I got a little bit of olive oil inside the crock pot. Got the fire on about medium. And I'm gonna go ahead and throw my carrots and sugar snap peas onto the wok and get them started. Guys, while those veggies are over there doing their thing, come over here and we're gonna dice up some onion. And make a little bit of a mess. This is excellent. I love this cutting board. Save you so much time. Just like that. Boom. Onions. Done. Okay. All right, guys. We got onions here. And we got a pepper from our garden. Of course, we're going to saute these. And nothing livens up a dish better to me than onions and bell pepper sauteed. So we're going to get us a little bit of this, and boom, damn, that is excellent. So got those ready. We're going to flavor up that rice perfectly. Okay. Let's go check on our vegetables. Alright, guys, these vegetables are looking like they're good to go. They're ready. You know? I like my beans to still have a little bit of crunch to them, so we can go ahead and take them off just like this and set them off to the side. Okay. Starting to get there. Guys, I mean, as y'all can see, there's a lot of prep that goes into this, but there is a way for you to actually make this process a lot shorter. Make sure you go ahead and get your rice done, have it done. You can cook it the day before. Even in a lot of cases, you can fry your chicken the day before, or go ahead and get it cut up and prepared, you know, earlier that day or the day before, just so you can cut the time in half. Alright, it's a lot of little pieces to this, and it can take a little while, you know.
But, babe, don't you sometimes fry your chicken and freeze it?
Yeah. That's a good way to go ahead and get it prepared. Go ahead and get it prepared and put it up, and then when it's time, you can just go ahead and pull it out, refry it, and get on with it, you know what I mean? But you go ahead and give it a second fry, it warms it up, it crispies the skin up again, and you're good to go. So that is always an option. Make sure, you know, if you don't have the time or you plan on doing this, you know, that you take all that into consideration. Okay. We're going to go ahead and dump our vegetables in there with our onions and peppers and throw it off to the side just a little bit. Got a little bit of scallion. We're going to go ahead and toss that in the mix. Together, do what it needs to do. Throw the shrimp back in there. Let it go ahead and get flavored up with what we got going on. Okay. rice. I can see I don't play like that. I make sure my rice is full. Can y'all taste that? Man, do we need to do anything else to that? No, I think that is excellent, just like that. Like, it is perfect. But, we got more to do. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and take this off the fire for a little while. Put it in a bowl all together. Throw our rice in. Don't have to use as much rice. You can use less or more, depending on you, the size of your family, however you decide you want to get it done. I know different places, you know, the taste are different, so therefore I try not to give no specifics when it comes to ingredients, because you know what you like. You know what you like, use more what you like. Less of what you don't, but you know, make sure you keep a good balance so you can actually enjoy what is actually supposed to taste like. Sauce in the mix. I hear you talking to me, Jacob. Let's do it. Let's get it going. I'm gonna fry up that rice. I want to fry it. Come on, baby. Come here. Beautiful color I'm looking for. I got no soy sauce in. Can be a little saucy, so you gotta make sure you balance that out. Make sure you're careful with how much you use, because you don't want to overdo it. Then we're gonna take our mixture, put it back in there. We gonna let, come on, all the juices, I want them all, come on. Okay, come on out of here. We're gonna make it do. Yes, yes, yes. a little bit more of my soy sauce in there. Because I want my vegetables and the shrimp to all get a little touch of it. Do it. Amazing. I can taste it. It's gonna be great. My little lady, she'll be happy. Now lastly, I'm gonna go ahead and put my eggs in there. Alright? I say lastly, but we're gonna do a little bit more to it than that. I'm gonna go ahead and put them in there. Those that need to do too much more cooking, so we want to make sure they're good. Pop that up real quick and let it do a little fast cook. Best thing is if you're going to play with that thing hot, you're going to have to stay on it. One thing I like to do, some people put sugar, pineapple juice, and chunks of pineapple are something that I have started doing whenever I did my rice, and it is good, so try it if you like. You would not be sorry. The sweet and savory is amazing. Put chunks of pineapples in there to taste. You know what I mean? You don't want to overdo it, but you do. Oops. Sous chef. I made a mess.
We were talking jackfruit with Urban Girl Garden. Okay.
What she had to say about it?
She cooked jackfruit pulled pork last night. Pork.
How did it come out?
Great. Her husband said it was banging. Mm.
It's amazing how you can get something that's supposed to be a fruit that tastes like meat. You know, I think that's the argument that a lot of vegans use, and you know, I have not yet to experience that, but I am a carnivore, so I am very familiar with the taste of meat. So to be able to fool me is probably not going to be something that's going to be easily done.
I can take all this.
Oh, what?
This stuff here.
Yeah, you can take that.
Okay.
I am going to need a big bowl.
Okay.
Okay. Guys. Oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
My goodness.
You're gonna put a little bit more of that pineapple juice in there. Got me a tablespoon of ginger. Go ahead and throw some peppers in there. Be careful with them. You want to just put your mixture in. And let it simmer. Alright guys, I see my sauce is thickening up. This is what we're looking for. The kind of consistency. So that's about ready. Okay, I have to put my chicken back in to get that second frying. So then they're doing that. Alright guys, this step is not necessary, but I love the taste of honey, so I do put some in. Not needed, it will take some reason without it, but a little extra. You got that second fry on that chicken. I'm gonna go ahead and simply put them together. And we're just gonna toss these and coat them with all this deliciousness. So. Refried chicken into your sauce, you stir it, coat, and it is done. You're ready. Looks delicious, and I am ready. All right, guys, that's the finished product. You know, we got some rice and we got some chicken, general size. wife her food and see what she think. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe to our channel. We appreciate everything y'all doing for us. We appreciate the growth.
Thanks, boy. This chicken, it's still a little crunchy.